Russian Naval Shipyard, Kola Peninsula, Russia, January 26, 2005, 2014 hours. Information collected at the Kola facility indicates that the cell operating under the command of Colonel Alexeyevich has standing orders to capture a Russian submarine manufacturing facility on the Kola Peninsula. Third echelon monitoring reveals that the Russian nuclear submarine Vselka is currently docked at the facility. The submarine must be located and Alexeyevich's remaining men must be stopped. Greetings, fellow Wotlings, welcome back to more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell in First Person Perspective. This is the second bonus mission, and it sort of serves as the first part of the Vselka bundle, which is basically Vselka Infiltration and Vselka Submarine. This mission is about getting into the submarine, while the next mission will be about rampaging about the submarine. I sure do hope that they allow kills for this mission, because if this mission is alarm or stealth sensitive, then it is going to be a pretty difficult one. But it might also not be the case. Let us see. Anyway, without further ado, I am curious about how things led to this. But let's go.
We've updated your objectives. Your first target is a Russian sailor. We spotted him by drone. We think he's the only shipyard employee left alive.
What makes him so special that they let him live?
That's what we want you to find out.
And that's as short a conversation that we can get. No more information about it. I mean, how did they even, you know, get information about this Russian submarine or the sailor? We have no clue. We just know that there's like a submarine docked in the Vselka, you know, station, and we need to do something about it. That is all, literally all we know about this mission. But anyway, let's get on with it, I guess. And unfortunately, I'm having to take the long way around, you know, shimmying around this place, because I tried getting down from a closer point, but Sam would refuse to, you know, keep hanging on. He would rather fall into the water instead. So yeah, I think that is just something that the game development should have probably paid a little more attention to, but didn't. Let me just quick save here, and I'll be right back. And this does not seem to be a good time for us to get up there. I will let the dog pass. Yes, that is good. I hope. Is that... are those my footsteps? Like, are those fish's footsteps? I really can't tell, to be honest. And I hope they can't see me up here. I'm just gonna quick save and attempt this jump, because that's pretty much the only way over here. I've got to take a rope line. Where's the rope line? I think it's tied to the spool. Anyway, quick saving. Again, just for luck.
Who is that?
And we made it. That's cool. Yeah, so this is basically the rope line that we need to tether to. Can I like jump up and grab it? No? Ah, got it. Cool. Actually, I mean,
who's out there?
If I wanted to play this as a tactical shooter mod, I probably should have I did not mean to get up here. Yeah, I probably should have just killed those people outright, but I did not. So I guess I can't. What the least I can do is just shoot this guy at least. Keeping it true to the genre. Now, the problem is disposing of his body, because, well, there are some shadows here which we can use. A satchel. And the body. Ooh, we got a flare in case we want to distract the camera. Not the camera, rather the turret. I guess that is good enough, I don't know. Might not be. But this is also the best I can do for the time being. Let's hope it does not trigger an alarm. And I hope there are no alarm requirements for this mission, because they don't say anything about that. Let me just go and save you. So, I wonder if we can just shoot this camera out, instead of, you know, having to disable it with the camera jammer. Yes, we can. That is convenient, and I should do just that. There is another body here. I wonder whose body it is. Probably a sailor's. Anyway, time for me to open this door, and where is the pipe that we wanted to grab? I think it's one of these. Should be. Because that's like one of the ways we can cross this section. The other is to probably sneak by the shadows, which requires an insane amount of timing. Anyway, so basically I need to shoot this camera out as well. Of course I do. Why didn't I think of that? So yeah, this is basically one of the ways you can sneak past this turret. The other would be to time it precisely from the right hand side, and if you don't kill that guard outside or knock him out, it's going to be pretty difficult. And we see from this camera as well, but we just need to wait here for a bit because there's going to be another guy who's coming out shortly. Or I think, as far as I remember anyway. Is there another guy that's going to come out here? Let me just quick see and find out anyway. Yeah, so apparently there is somebody that likes to, you know, come inside. And so basically we just got to use the disposable pick here and make a break for it. If we want to sneak by that guy, that is. Let me just get inside here and save, because I feel like there are a few more guys that are going to come downstairs right now. I'm not sure though. I definitely don't want to be out in the light where I can get caught. I can hear them moving about pretty close to me. Yep, they're already here. So, a lot of parts of, like a few parts of this level, that guy has a shotgun. That would do some heavy damage. I wonder if he shoots it like a shotgun. Anyway, I'll just wait for the door to close before heading up back upstairs. Oh wait, let me just quick save here.
That's exactly why I'm staying put.
You don't care about.
I don't care about anything but getting paid. Now I've gotten paid, I want to be around to spend the money.
Makes sense.
Hey man, I got nothing on you that you don't got on me.
Yeah. Don't forget.
Don't forget? Don't forget what, son? Am I going the right way? Was I supposed to get in there? Or am I going too high at this point in time? I forgot. Maybe I was supposed to go down there. I think I was supposed to go down here first. Yeah, I was supposed to go down here first. I don't know why I can still hear people moving about, but this camera can be taken out, and I will do just that. Oh, why am I in the light here? Oh, because there's like a light on me, I'm guessing? Curious. I'm guessing there should be somebody patrolling these corridors as well. Could be wrong, of course. I can hear somebody moving about there, but I'm guessing that's the people downstairs, so I'm just gonna risk it. It has been some time since I last played this level, so I don't recall all the details, but yeah, I should recall enough just to get me by.
Eating like that, you are going to get fat.
I can't help myself. My own mother never cooked so well. Maybe you didn't salt her well enough.
Be nice. Anyway, we need to get back to our patrol.
Relax. Nothing's going to happen.
This is the
us and our sailor friend both. But dinner is over. Come on, Arkady. Let's get back to our post.
Arkady. Of course. There's somebody called Arkady here. I hope none of them come towards me. Yeah, I'm finally in the shadows and I'm planning to keep it that way. Let me just go ahead and shoot this guy out while I can.
Who is that?
That was a very sloppy shot. Is nobody going to come and investigate? Because I think there's somebody out there. Yes, there is. Come here, son. Come here, let me see you when you're in the shadows so that I can shoot you. Good, good, good. And we have got a satchel for us to use, a data stick, and we've got another satchel here. Babarov is in the cafeteria freezer, door code 310. That's it, 310? It's like a 3-digit door code. Ouch. Yeah, we gotta use this keypad better. Cool, that was my first 3-digit door code. At any rate, I'll just wait for this door to close.
Babarov.
You're not one of them. Quickly, untie me.
No. But I do have a few questions.
You're not here to help me?
I'm not here at all. I can't take you with me, and if I untie you, it'll only mean trouble when the Spetsnaz find you. I don't have much time, and I need to know why you're alive.
Oh, God!
They killed everybody but you. Why?
I'm a submariner. I operate the broadcast system on the Vselka. She's docked outside.
Broadcast system?
The submarine has a good communication system. Very flexible. The Azeris are using it to transmit signals north.
So how can I get at it?
You can't. Not now. They keep submarines submerged.
So how do you get at it?
With radio to the submarine from the compressor control room on the fourth floor. You need a passcode to get inside.
I'll bet you know that code.
Please. Untie me.
I'm getting cranky, Babarov.
The code is 8027.
Fisher, you're gonna need to get inside that sub.
I'm gonna need it to surface first.
We're working on it. I'll get back to you.
Yeah, it's sort of strange having to, you know, practically poke your head into somebody's head to talk to them, but I'm guessing this is good enough for a screenshot, if not maybe this.
We figured out how you can force the sub up. If you deactivate the compressor, you'll only have a few minutes to decide between surfacing or sinking to the bottom and suffocating. Details on your upside.
I don't think I'm going to be making any friends on this job.
Fish has got jokes. Now, what to do about this guy here, I wonder. I mean, I could probably knock him out right here. Yeah, I guess I'll just wait for him to go there before I do my thing. Easier to transport him into shadows that way, I assume. What did I get from the satchel, though? I must have gotten something from the satchel. This should be good enough to hide his body. Seems good enough to me. All these other sounds that I'm hearing are sort of throwing me off. Now, of course, this was not a combat situation and we did not need to shoot these guys, but I just sort of like doing it anyway. Well, there does not seem to be anybody on the other side of the wall. And we need to go upstairs. So, let us get to it. I don't think anybody comes out at this point, but if they do, then we're sort of screwed. Yeah, I don't think anybody's coming out from here. The door code should be, I mean, we just heard him say the door code, but so, 8027. come on. Come on. Yeah. Let us try this code now. Okay, which one? They all seem the same color. Now I can't see any keys at all. This is gonna be guesswork. I'm guessing this button. Oh, it was just a 3-digit code. No wonder.
GPS shows you within a stone's throw of the compressor. Get ready to move once you've thrown it. The men coming out of that sub aren't going to be happy.
You're underestimating my charm.
I'm just trying to fit in. Watch yourself.
So, that door is sealed with a... I'm just going to make a save for this. That door is fit with a retinal scanner, as far as I can see. So what I'm going to need here is either of these two good-natured chaps. Let's hope they don't see me. Grab this guy and let me just go ahead and interrogate him, provided the game provides me the opportunity to.
Monkey.
That's it. Okay. Use the retina scanner. I'm guessing that was just one of the, you know, extra voice lines that they wanted Fisher to use. And there's gonna be a guy in here. Well, it does not seem to be the case, so I guess we're safe for now.
Thanks.
So, do we take these lights out? It sure would play an advantage to do so. Yeah. Let us open this crate as well. Now, typically, I would avoid, that's a bulletproof camera, but these lights aren't bulletproof. Okay, did the crate? Of course it did. Anyway, so, yeah, there are lasers on either side. Since I'm a second jumping over them, I'll just duck under one of these. Typically, I like to play this section stealthily. And it was actually thrilling to try out a new path to this level. I had not thought of doing this before. I had subverted the route entirely. It wasn't until recently that I got the inspiration to try it. And I think either the PS2 version or the Xbox version has bonus lasers around here. I'm not sure though. Anyway, or maybe a camera. Yeah, one of these versions has a camera as well, which keeps looking at you while you sort of do your thing here. I'm just gonna quick save here, because things are gonna get ugly after this, and I do intend to take part in the shootout. Let me just go ahead and equip the grenades. No, we could be long gone before they come in.
They have an unauthorized presence in the compressor room. Send a team immediately. Intruder in the submarine compressor room.
Now, let's see how we can play this. That's the retinal scanner in action. The sound of the retinal scanner. I'm going to be using my gas grenades. I'm guessing there's nobody else. I shot that guy because it was taking a little too long to get knocked out. Sometimes it just so happens that these guys don't actually get knocked out. So that actually went relatively well. For a first-person tactical shooter mode, I mean, it was completely tactical and no shooter involved sort of thing. Anyway, I'll just save here again. And we got a satchel here. what did we get from the Satchel of Fleer, of course. Now, yeah, I don't need to pick this guy up. Oh, come on. See, I don't even know if I've dropped the body or not unless I'm actually looking at it. Sort of redundant if you ask me, but okay. Whatever gets your rockers off. So if you can see some masses that you want to neutralize, might as well use the smoke grenades. So I usually typically go through here, and in my previous playthrough I did the same, but this time I wanted to try out the Chinese embassy hack, and guess what? It actually works. I'm assuming there's nobody who's going to be, you know, coming upstairs. Oh yeah, there is somebody. I'm just going to stay in a quiet little corner here. And hope that they can't see me when they do go up. I mean, despite everything that this mod does, I really do enjoy playing Splinter Cell as stealthily as possible. So, yeah. That is what you see me doing here. And these are obviously not the guys that we saw going down, because one of them had a shotgun. Let me just go under here and save again. Something happened there, and it was not pretty, I can guarantee you that much. I mean, just look at this guy. Was he trying to check a grenade or something? Anybody else I need to be worried about? I don't think so. I mean, I think that's the end of it. I don't think there's anybody up ahead. Yep, it's the end of the level. And we'll be heading over into some circus arena. And that's it. Fantastic work, Fisher. Actually, the mission is not complete. You just divided, these guys just divided it into, you know, two segments. That is Vselka Submarine and Vselka Infiltration. Because apart from that, the next mission is Vselka Submarine. So our mission is actually still not done yet. But yeah, let's go ahead and do this, I guess. The next mission is also pretty tedious. The first bit, at least, you need to be a little stealthy, because if you aren't, then, well, they don't open a certain door for you which you need to be opened. So yeah, it's a little confusing, but it is what it is. Can't really do much about it. So I'll see you guys in the next mission, which is, I'm gonna play it now anyway. But yeah, until then, take care, farewell, fellow things.